Hey guys, how's it going? Today is day one of the Cuba adventure, all right? So the Cuban adventure. I'm standing right here in front of the money exchange, dollar exchange, because right now I'm still in Merida and this is the pre-game, you know, the pre-trip. They're pre-getting ready for the trip. So, you know, one of the things that you got to do is, you know, get your money right. You got to get your money exchanged correctly. So that way, when you get over there to Cuba, you get the best possible exchange rate and the best possible, you know, bang for your buck. So, as I was getting ready for this trip, you know, I realized that, you know, there's a lot of things that I had to, you know, research and take care of, you know, before I actually embarked on this journey. I thought it was going to be actually pretty easy peasy, you know, not so difficult, but it was actually a little bit more difficult than what I anticipated. And, you know, one of the difficulties actually came from the price shock, you know, of what Cuba was going to cost me. You know, the flight over there, pretty cheap, and, you know, the Airbnb stay, also pretty cheap. But as I was researching pretty much everything from the taxis to, you know, just you know, a lot of the food and a lot of the stuff, you know, the touristy stuff and a lot of just things, it seems like it's going to be really expensive. And then as I was you know, gathering information of others that have gone on this trip already, they've told me, you know, they've said similar stories as well, that is actually going to be, it is actually pretty expensive. So to me, I'm actually taking more than what I thought I was going to take. And I hope I don't have to spend it all, because as you guys know, I'm a little tight on money still. So to me, I'm just gonna take more than, you know, I thought I was gonna take, just in case, you know, there's some sort of emergency, some sort of situation in which I might need a few extra bucks, because there's no ATMs, there's no credit, there's no nothing. So neither me or Chris are gonna have any real access to that. Now, I think that Chris, as a Mexican, will have access, you know, to her banking, you know, over there in Cuba. But again, as you guys know, if she has trouble banking here within Mexico, like a lot of people do, then you know, we're not gonna put all our marbles in one basket, you know, and like I'm hoping that it's gonna work over there type of shit. So, you know, we're gonna just eliminate that and just go with cash only, which seems to be, you know, the way to go. Now, real quick, I'm gonna see if I can capture a quick thumbnail. The trials and tribulations of a YouTuber. All right. So as you're watching this, I'm already about a week back. All right. So like I've already been back about a week. All right. And you know, for those of you guys that don't know, like since I do have daily uploads, you know the way I'm able to achieve that is by you know, filming as many episodes as I can and taking as many opportunities as I can to film and then uploading them, you know, in due time, you know, having at least one upload a day. There's some people that do more than one, but I just do one a day so that way I have daily uploads. But anyway, you know, you guys came here to talk, you know, we're talking about Cuba and just a pregame about Cuba. So, you know, one of the things that I'm also going to be doing is that I got some family members over there, so I'm going to be taking an extra bag since we're only going for 3 days. Yeah, like 3 nights. We're only going for 3 days, 4 days, whatever. We're leaving on Thursday morning and coming back Sunday morning, Sunday noon, give or take. So that's about, you know, 3 days. But one of the things I'm going to do over there is I'm going to take some medicine and some, you know, just medical supplies, you know, for a family member that I have living over there that's already older in age. So another family member of mine that lives out here told me, hey, can you take her some stuff? I'm like, yeah, of course. So since we're not taking that much stuff, we're gonna split the luggage. You know, it's still, again, you know, when you're going to Cuba, you know, at least for me, for anyone coming out of here, you're only going for a few days for the most part. And I mean, how much do you really need for a few days? So, you know, I'm only taking clothes for a few days, taking my supplies for a few days, you know, clothes-wise, same as, you know, Christian. And then, you know, obviously we're gonna have, you know, plenty of room, you know, to take stuff for her, which, by the way, I've already, you know, pretty much packed all my stuff. So, you know, we got plenty of room and then some. So, you know, just to go with the carry-on luggage. So that's part of the trip. Now, you know, there's a lot more stuff about Cuba that I'm sure you guys are, you know, very curious about. And, you know, as I go to Cuba and I'm just traveling about and doing my thing, I'm going to be filming and talking. I'm probably going to do some of these videos, you know, walking and talking. I'm also going to do, you know, other kinds of videos with my other camera. I'm going to be taking pictures. I'm going to be doing a lot of that stuff. And I can't wait, actually. You know what I mean? There's a lot of things, you know, I can't wait to go do. Now, you know, to me, like, one of the main concerns about my trip more than anything else is the budget, because again, now I'm on a Mexican budget, and so just being on a Mexican budget going to somewhere like Cuba is three times the price, because it's like visiting Miami, it's like visiting any other country. So, you know, that's one of the things that I'm kind of like being, you know, prepared for, you know, taking enough money, like if I was going to go visit Miami, you know, and that's the thing, you know, as opposed to like if I'm going to visit another part of Mexico, I'm not going to be spending that kind of money. I'm going to be spending a little bit of money. And so, you know, to me, you know, that's one of the things that I have, you know, just a little bit of concern with, but that's pretty much it. Other than that, like, you know, what that tells me, and, you know, even with Christian, you know, as we're watching a lot of videos and vlogs and all kinds of things on Merida, Mexico, I mean, on Cuba, on, you know, visiting La Habana and visiting Cuba, you know, from, you know, a Mexican's perspective, is the, you know, the fact that, you know, things are actually more expensive. So, like, in a weird way, it seems like the economy and things are doing way better over there than over here. Now, of course, that's not really true per se, because, you know, we've seen how things are here. We've seen how life is out here, not just in Merida, but also, you know, in Mexico, and I'm sure you've seen other vlogs and all that stuff. But, you know, after watching a lot of vlogs and a lot of people that live in Cuba, filming about Cuba, talking about Cuba, and just seeing a lot of stuff about Cuba, you know, just like you guys watch my Merida vlogs, you know, my Mexico vlogs for information and knowledge and just an insight on life out here. Well, I was watching some videos on that too, and it was very surprising to me that, yeah, there's difficulties, and, you know, life is kind of difficult, but in a sense, you know, it's just as difficult as a life for a typical Mexican out here. And, you know, it's kind of interesting, you know, it's really, really interesting. And then, like, how much money, you know, they actually make out there, because, you know, sure, you know, things are in the Mexican, things are in the Cuban peso, in the Cuban, you know, currency, but they have two Cuban currencies, and one, you know, one of the main Cuban currencies, you know, that they have is one that's one that's one-to-one to a dollar, like a tether, you know what I mean? But, you know, it's like this this CUC, you know, this Cuban convertible currency. And so that's like really what the whole economy runs on, just like how we were talking about Venezuela, and we're talking about other countries that, you know, have either their own currencies that are pegged to the dollar, or an actual you know, or they're actually using the actual dollar as currency. So, you know, right now it's not any different. And so, you know, one of the tips, you know, to go out there, you know, like, I don't know if I'm gonna be the tip guy, but one of the tips is to go with euros, because when you go with euros, you actually get more bang for your buck. And what do I mean? Well, the thing is that if you go with dollars to Cuba, like, actually, you know, like US dollars, they actually tax you 10%. So there's like a 10% tax on your exchange rate. And then you get like a lower exchange rate. You get like a 97, 90 something percent exchange rate. So let's just say you take $100, you know, the exchange rate that you would get back would be, you know, like out of $100, you probably get like $85, $88, something like that. You know what I mean? Give or take. And then if you were to go with euros, you know, you actually get a 1.1 or 1.1 something or 1.1 whatever exchange rate. So, you know, you would actually get more back, and you don't get taxed 10%. So euros are the way to go. So if I were you, find a way to get those euros exchanged. But, you know, also do the math, you know, be correct, because I've seen other YouTubers, you know, they would go out there and be like, oh yeah, I went to the bank, I went here, and they charged me so and so much money, you know, in order to get these euros, and it had to wait. Listen, you know, do the math, you know what I mean? If it's gonna cost you more, all right, just do some simple math, that's what school was for, right? But if it's gonna cost you more to go through all the hassle and then get the money from the bank, they're gonna charge you and all this other crap, then don't go that route. Just take dollars and exchange them at the airport or something, all right? But, you know, the way to go was either, you know, go with Mexican pesos or euros. But I'm gonna opt in and go with euros, because not only do I get a more favorable exchange rate than if I were to go with Canadian dollars or Mexican pesos or anything like that, it's just the fact that they would be easier to interchange over there, you know, just in case, you know, so in case I gotta have an emergency where I gotta exchange some money, euro is a lot easier exchange than anything else, as opposed to like Mexican pesos or anything else. And so, you know, when I get out there, I'm gonna see if I can exchange most of my money at the airport, And then, you know, when I get to, you know, when I get to, like the city, I'll have most of my money already exchanged. And then just in case there's an emergency, then I'll be able to go to a hotel or some other place where I can exchange my money. All right. And I'll do that. You know what I mean? But that's like the tip, because for everything I hear, you get the best exchange rate no matter what at the airport. And in this case, I'm going to be able to exchange it, I think, here in Mérida before I even get to Cuba. So, and I'll probably be able to get a better exchange rate since I already did all my math and my homework. I already know what to look for, what to get, and so on and so forth. And yeah, so, you know, even though right now I have pesos and dollars and I'm gonna exchange them for euros, and it seems that I'm gonna be losing money, after I did all my math, it actually comes out to, yeah, as a matter of fact, I'm gonna be getting a lot more back to spend in Cuba, because again, everything runs on these kooks. All right, now, again, you're watching this before I leave. I'm leaving still in a couple of days, and this is like, again, still before my birthday, and you know, I'm still just getting ready a bunch of things before I head out of here and go. So, you know, to me, I wasn't even gonna be filming anything today, but I felt like I wanted to film something, so I actually brought my camera out here. I've actually been on vacation mode for a few days. I'm sure some of you guys that are constant viewers of my channel already know that. You already know that I've been on like a little bit of a hiatus. You know, right now, all I'm doing is that, like, I'm just doing the pregame. So, like, actually, I was gonna come out here and, you know, film a walk and talk on my way back. But when I got here, it just turned out that the person was out to lunch. So now I just, like, fuck, I got like 20, 30 minutes to kill. So I was like, oh, perfect. I guess I'm gonna film the episode now. And, you know, maybe I'll film another one afterwards. But all I was talking about today, you know, all I really want to talk about today is just, you know, just, I guess, like my pregame before Cuba. So, you know, the visa situation, you know, like that visa situation, everywhere I try to get information, I even called the airport, called the airline, called everybody. And they said that pretty much I'll get the visa when I get there. And that's it. And then... what else do I gotta take care of? And then that's it. Okay, so some of the things that I was advised to take to Cuba, you know, because there's not gonna be any kind of like Wi-Fi or electricity or anything like that, was to take a lot of printed things, you know, so like printed maps, you know, printed, the tickets, you know, printed addresses, printed everything. So, you know, one of the things that I'm doing is that I went online and I went to Maps. First of all, download this app if you're going to be going out there, which I already did. I downloaded this app called Maps.me or Maps.me or Maps.me, whatever. And so that app, you know, allows you to download maps for any area that you're at. And then it allows you to access it, you know, again, in airplane mode, you know, which is how it's going to be out there in Cuba. And then also in Google. And Google Maps. So one thing that you can do, which I already did as well, is that I went to my Google Maps, all right, on my phone. All right, and I went to, you know, Havana, Cuba on my phone. And then, hey, how's it going? All right, 1 second.
Jose!
Hey, how's it going?
You got some fans? I watch you.
Oh my gosh.
How's it going? Who are you guys?
We've been looking for you. We knew you were going to be somewhere. We're going to run into you.
Well, always. Yeah, for sure.
Oh, you're on right now.
I'm on right now. I'm filming right now.
Introduce
yourselves. No, it's too late now.
This is Candace.
Candace?
And I'm Jaime.
Jaime, okay. Hey, you sent me an email, right?
Yes.
Okay,
yes.
Perfect. All right. Well, I'll be right back, guys.
Jose, number one.
Thanks, man. You guys are number one. Thank you so much. It was a great conversation.
Thank you for your videos, Jose.
Oh. I did not pay them to say that, I swear.
Where's my money?
I said afterwards. All right, well, okay, we're back. So, honestly, I don't even remember what the hell I was talking about. I felt like I was just rambling about a bunch of nonsense, as usual. But as you guys saw, bumped into some fans. These are actually fans that already emailed me, and you know, I was waiting for a response on when to get together, you know, on when we were gonna get together, because again, as you guys know, I'm getting ready to leave soon. So to me, you know, I wasn't, you know, gonna set anything up anytime soon. But anyways, it was just funny because they were telling me how they were putting it out there in the universe that they were gonna bump into me, they were gonna meet up with me, they were gonna see me, and all they had to do was just walk down Paseo Montejo. And again, sure enough, bam, you know, like I'm always saying, like I'm always, you know, telling you guys in the whole nine. And yeah, you know, she bumped into me. They both bumped into me, and you know, we had a nice conversation, and we were just you know, chatting about exactly what I was just saying right now and a bunch of other things. And you know, it was really cool and really interesting. So you know, just to, I guess, piggyback off of what they were telling me in the conversation that we were having, you know, about, you know, just like what I'm always telling you guys, you know, where it's just about putting it out there in the universe, but then putting in that works, you know. So again, they knew that, you know, they wanted to bump into me. So, you know, they sent me emails. I responded, you know, but they wanted to still see me. So they go, you know what, we're going to walk down Paseo Montejo. And sure enough, you know, we'll bump into him. I wasn't planning on walking out. I wasn't planning on doing anything. And again, it was the reason I started making the video was because, again, in a stationary position was because I was waiting for the money exchange person to open up and wake up, you know, and finish their lunch. Which, by the way, you know, by the time I got back, it was still overtime, and she was still upset that I was interrupting her me time. You know, I'm talking about the currency exchange lady. But anyways, the point is that I was just there waiting for them. At first I was like a little upset. I was like, fuck, man, I wanted to just get it over with. So I was like, you know what, I'll make a video to entertain myself. And then bam, you know what I mean, that's how I bumped into them. So it's like, you see how things don't even happen in my life in a certain, you know, fashion, so that they work out for them as well, and vice versa. And then, you know, we finally got to meet, even before we actually met, and it was really interesting and cool. But you know, one of the things that we were actually talking about, you know, was the fact of you know, having to you know, the little last minute struggle for anyone that's packing to take a trip goes through. So, you know, even though I started the video trying to, you know, let you guys know about my trials and tribulations, you know, on my trip out to Mexico, you know, basically, you know, what I kept saying from the beginning, you know, the biggest hurdle here, which I think it's for most people, it's a financial thing. And to me, you know, Cuba, I'm not even gonna lie to you, like I originally thought that it would have been one of these places where you could go and it was actually gonna be really cheap and inexpensive. But as I started doing my research, I realized that that was quite the opposite. And you know, sometimes, you know, like when you're doing like some of the traveling that I do, or backpacking or what have you, you know, it does pay, it does pay off to do a little research, you know, because especially if you're going to be there for, you know, a little while, or if, you know, you have specific needs or there's, you know, things like that. So my needs at the moment were financial, you know, usually it's not something I worry about, but at this moment, it's something that I unfortunately have to, you know, keep into consideration. So in order for me to travel with my girlfriend and have like a rich experience, I just got to do my homework and my research, and that's it. That way I don't get there and I'm like, oh, this sucks, you know, I'm poor, I can't do anything, which is not the case at all. And we know, remember, rich in life, right? Like Bob Marley says,
have you made a lot of money out of your music?
Money, I mean, what is, how much is a lot of money to you?
Yeah, that's a good question. Have you made, say, millions of dollars?
No.
Are you a rich man?
What do you mean rich? What do you mean?
Do you have a lot of possessions? A lot of money in the bank?
Position make you rich? I don't have that type of richness. My richness is life, forever.
It's all about being rich in life. And that's it, you know what I mean? So, you know, this is why, you know, one of the reasons why I'm choosing to go, you know, to Cuba as well, is that, like, you know, as I was doing research, I could have easily canceled it or gone anywhere else. And there was many, many things, you know, many hurdles for me to personally, you know, jump through and all these other things, you know. But eventually I said, you know, I have to go, you know what I mean? And it's like, I feel like it was like almost like a little bit of a pilgrimage, like something that I just had to do. And that all these hurdles were put there on purpose in order to see, you know, again, like I say all the time, you know what I mean? What the fuck I'm made out of and all that. And, you know, sure enough, you know, as I sit here just a couple days before I go, a day and a half pretty much, I'm like, I haven't been this excited to take a trip in a very long time. And, you know, before, I'm not gonna, you know, this was just a visa run, you know, more than anything else. And so I just said to myself, well, this is the cheapest visa run, you know, I could possibly take per se. And it turned into, and now it's turned into something completely different, you know. And again, just like this video, I started out with just talking about, I guess, like pre-game tips on Cuba and stuff like that. But it turned out to just be my, my journal, you know, on my my life, you know, my situation out here, you know, meaning, you know, my trip and what I'm going through, what I'm thinking about, and a lot of these things. And it's just, you know, a lot of the pre-game jitters were actually taken away by watching other YouTube videos and other YouTubers out there, you know, going through, whether it's going through a lot of the similar, you know, travel experiences or just living out there or whatever. And so, you know, now I, you know, understand the value of the videos that I'm making as well, because, you know, in a certain extent, like when I make these videos, I just, I make them because, I don't know, I just want to make them and I think they're cool and it's fun and I like it. And it's, you know, that's why I'm always saying I'm doing it for me, and because I kind of am. I'm just, I enjoy this stuff. I enjoy talking to you guys, having an audience. Everything that I'm building, it's just fun, you know. It's hard to even describe. It's like asking someone, like, why do you enjoy playing with your hobby, or building, you know, little toy planes or whatever, you know what I mean? It's like, or playing with Legos, or playing with, or being a fan of comic books. It's like that weird of a, it's a deep question. It's like, I don't know why I like doing it, but I just like doing it. And it's the same thing with all that stuff. So, you know, with that being said, you know, like, that's why, like, my mentality towards a lot of this stuff is a little different, because it's not, I don't know, it wasn't until, you know, me getting ready for this trip and actually doing homework and looking at other YouTubers and, you know, now that I built what I built, you know, bumping into like fans and just going through all that stuff, it's changed my perspective on a lot of things. Man, it is crazy hot. And it's just gonna be as hot in Cuba, by the way. So I'm gonna be sweating balls over there. I thought it was gonna be cooler, but it's not. But yeah, you know, I've realized the importance of a lot of these videos, because before I used to just do the traveling and I never really did any research. But, and even when I was making these videos, you know, to me, it's like I'm just making, you know, vlogging, just, you know, like a journal, you know, stuff like that. But, you know, it's like I really understand the importance of everything I do. As I was getting ready for my trip, as I see more and more people all the time, you know, that I know. Hey, how's it going?
You could stop for a minute?
Sure,
come
sure.
On, you're recording.
Yeah. You guys know me from YouTube, huh?
Yeah, sure. I checked your blog. Yeah.
That's awesome.
No, I've checked your blog. You know, you talk about living in here, some of the sights to see here.
Yeah.
And one day, you was a little bit, disgruntled of something that you encountered, right? And you were articulating it as you were walking.
Sure.
You know, and I say, well, he's natural. He letting you know how it is. You know what I mean? But as I see you coming and uttering,
yeah,
I said, man, I just have to acknowledge.
Hi.
You know,
yeah, man. Hey, well, welcome, man.
Hey, man.
For sure.
Yeah.
Nice to meet you.
You too.
Because this is our first time.
Well, look at that. Well, isn't that something peachy? So, yeah, you know, like, I just, some, you know, I don't even know what to say. I don't know if you saw them walking behind me, but I just turned the camera on as soon as I finished that interaction. But yeah, you know, other people that watch my videos, and you know, for the, just the value of helping them out on what it is to, like, live out here or travel out here and stuff like that. And so to me, it's like, again, now I really, 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 really get to understand it, because I myself, you know, have done the same thing. I'm doing the same thing, you know, looking at other, you know, not just YouTubers, you know, you know, when I'm doing this whole travel to Cuba thing, but there's other YouTubers that I watch that I mentioned sometimes briefly, but I don't really, you know, others, you know, that travel all around, you know, Eastern Europe, you know, like Bald and Bankrupt. I love Bald and Bankrupt. You know, my girlfriend doesn't like him so much, but I love him. Same as Harold Balder. You know, he travels all over. He's just in Italy. He was in India before that, and so on and so forth. And they do videos, you know, more like, you know, filming like this. But regardless, you know what I mean? The same kind of style. And, you know, there's a bunch of us out here. And I love what I do. You know what I mean? I really love what I do. And I'm glad that it's, like, they were just saying, like, you know, that I bring value and I bring help. You know, just like I was getting value and help from others. And, you know, to me, it's just, you know, it's very, very awe-inspiring. You know, like, it's very, very, very humbling that I get to do that, you know, like, for others. And, it's really cool. I think there was some sort of accident. I don't know. Interesting. I'm always Mr. Nosy. You can tell I'm Hispanic, right? Disculpa. And so, you know, just to finish off this video, you know, I just really, for reals, like, it was very, very humbling that, you know, as I was making this video, I got to bump into two two completely separate different individuals before that, you know what I mean? Like, as in other days prior, you know, as I've been going out, you know what I mean? Like, I've been seeing more and more people that know me, and it's just really crazy humbling, and it's just really interesting. And you know, again, just I take a completely different perspective on what I do now, more than anything else. And I see that you know, it really does provide a lot of value, and you know, everything that I talk about, and that to me is just, again, I'm just venting and talking to my friends out here and stuff like that. And I don't look at it in that sense, but you know, I'm glad that again, I'm here and I can help you guys, and vice versa, because you guys help me. And you know, I'm not just talking about the other YouTubers out there, I'm talking about you guys, you know, you guys, the fans out there, because as you know, I meet you guys, and I make new friends with you guys all the time. It's very interesting, because in a way, we already are friends, you know what I mean? Just like I'm friends with other YouTubers, even though I'm not friends with other YouTubers. And that whole idea, like, I totally get that now. And it's like, because you guys know me, because I share so much about me with you guys. And then when we finally do meet, it's, you guys get to show me about you guys. And it's, you know, there's only so much you can know about me, right? But then it's really cool that I get to know so much more about you guys. And it's just really cool and really interesting. And the fact that we're all able to use this technology in order to be more connected to each other and find each other and stuff like that. Because, you know, again, you know, right now we have this really, really cool technology and this really cool stuff that's called the internet and YouTube and all this other stuff that allows us to connect, you know, and find each other more than anything else. Because that's another thing too, you know, in order for people to find me, or yeah, because that's how it works, you know, you guys have to find me, or me finding the channels that I like, I have to actually physically look for them. Sure, the algorithms help, you know, with the search, and they help with certain other things like that, you know, in order to make the finding easier. But for the most part, it's we have to find, you know what I mean, you have to find me. And so that's what, like, the coolest part about all this stuff is too. It's like, not only do you have to find me, but you have to stay tuned, you know, like, you have to actually like me. And you know, there's no incentive here, you know what I mean? Like, the only incentive is that you like me and I entertain you. And you know, just like the incentive of being friends with somebody, you know, that thing. So, you know, that's why this whole thing is, like, very crazy humbling. And the more I meet you guys, it's even more, you know, crazy cool and humbling. And you know, that's it. So, all right, guys, I'm gonna let you guys go, because I'm pretty much almost home already, and I've been filming a lot today. And today is just gonna be, like, I guess, a vlog of random thoughts and random things, because even though it started off as you know, me getting ready for my Cuba trip, it really, you know, it turned out into, I don't know, a bit of a cathartic experience, you know, with you guys. And and man, is it hot. And I didn't bring my trusty rag, so that's why I'm a little hotter than usual, but I don't have mine, you know. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for being here. As always, don't forget to please like, please subscribe, please share, please hit that bell icon. And more importantly than anything else, please stay awesome. And I love you guys, and I'll see you guys on the other side. Peace out, and thanks again. Yeah.